Violet Ramis Stiel has a great story to tell. She is the daughter of writer, actor, and comedic legend Harold Ramis. And the new book, it's such a, I love this cover, Ghostbusters, Ghostbusters' Daughter. Much more than a Ghostbusters' Daughter. And I said this to you when you sat down. Nice to have you here this morning.
Thank you for having me.
I met Harold on a couple of occasions. The word's often overused, the mensch of all time.
He really was.
And so incredibly funny. Mm-hmm. And you said when he passed away, you felt that the public at large wanted more.
I did. I mean, there was just a huge sort of outpouring of love and grief, and people sharing stories with me that I was so happy to hear. So I wanted to do the same and be able to share what I knew of him with the world.
And all these huge movies, Caddyshack among them, and you were saying, though, the first time you realized, oh, my dad is this guy, was Ghostbusters.
Yeah, I was in third grade when Ghostbusters came out, so I was pretty popular.
The coolest kid in school at
Definitely.
That time.
Definitely.
Wow. And is that the blessing or the burden? Because
I mean, he always really enjoyed it, so that sort of gave me a positive way of thinking about it. He loved answering questions and talking to fans, and he was always really generous with his time.
Seth Rogen writes a lovely foreword about working with him. Harold played his dad in Knocked Up. Judd Apatow has things to say. Did you know your dad was always held in this esteem?
I mean, comedy nerds everywhere sort of worshipped him from the time I can remember. So, you know, I think he sort of thought of Judd and Seth as his comedy children in a way. They were always very upfront about his influence on their comedy perspective. And so it was nice that they got a chance to work together.
So this expert and this genius, but when he was doing Caddyshack, he was like, I don't even know what I'm doing.
Yeah, he had no idea. He used to call it his $6 million film school scholarship.
Artifacts in the book, his press card when he wrote for Playboy, and all these other things. As you were doing this, obviously grew up with him, you were close to him throughout. Did you discover stuff about him you didn't know?
I didn't. I mean, he was always so open with me. I was an only child for the first 13 years of my life, so he kind of took me everywhere with him and really didn't try to censor the world for me at all. So it was nice to see it all in one place, but no surprises.
Another huge hit is Groundhog Day, but that was a harder movie to make.
I think it was. You know, people felt he and Bill specifically, I guess that's what you're talking about. Yeah. I think both were very passionate about it, maybe had some differences of opinion, and I think that the filming was a little stressful for both of them.
I don't know if you look upon it this way. Are there works of your dad's that are your favorites because, I don't know, through your own sensibility you like them, or because you have a memory of, oh, this was a nice time?
I mean, I really love them all. I have specific affection for Vacation because I'm in it.
Okay.
As the girl without a tongue. But, you know, he put his heart and soul into everything he did, so I love all of them because they really represent where he was at that time in his life.
And then is it a melancholy experience? What's it like for you, I don't know, therapeutic to some regard? Because his passing away is sad, and he was ill for a long time, and people were not aware that he was ill, and all that.
It was sad, and it still is. I mean, it's something you never really get over. You just learn to live with it. But he left so much wonderful things behind, and I'm just really happy. I go back to those movies and to his interviews over and over again just to sort of get a little boost and feeling like he's with me.
And it's the rarest of circumstances, I think, where somebody's that talented and that nice. I'm sure other people have said that to you.
Yeah, he was kind of an outlier in that way. He was from Chicago, so he never sort of left behind his Midwestern values, and he was just a genuinely good person.
As you meet with your phrase, comedy nerds, which is not a bad phrase, and we're going to tell you about an opportunity to meet Violet at Book Soup in a second, what are the things people are asking you? Are they just want to hear stories, or what?
I think they want to hear stories, and they also want to share stories with me, which is great. Everyone's curious about sort of the old classics and his evolution as a filmmaker, but, you know, people just have a lot of affection for him, and so it's nice to feel that.
Wow. You really do get the warm fuzzies reading this. Violet will be at Book Soup in West Hollywood this Saturday. All the information here on the screen, booksoup.com, and the phone number there, 310-659-3110. Really nice to meet you.
Thank you,
Violet. Nice meeting you.
And congratulations on your birth.
Thanks.
And on this book. Thanks.
Thank you.